Kansas City, Missouri is on the map, we have a black hero.
His fearless, self-assigned actions, far above and beyond the normal call of duty, exemplify the finest traditions of the American combat soldier and reflected with highest credit upon Private First Class James and the Armed Forces of the United States. Accepting the Medal of Honor for Private First Class James is Valencia James, his widow.
This is a picture of our aunt receiving the Medal of Honor. This is Private First Class Willie James. And this is a sketch because there were no pictures of him, and an artist in Sierra Vista, Arizona sketched this picture from the memory of his wife, of Private First Class James' wife. I was helping her pay bills, and I was going through papers that she had not opened mail, and I happened to open this, and I'm like, Johnny, this is saying that she needs to call this person. It's about her husband receiving the Medal of Honor. That's how we met Willie James.
Another picture. This is when President Clinton was shaking her hand. I never did see him, never had a relationship with him. I learned that he lived in Kansas City, Missouri, and that he enlisted in the Army at an early age.
Only our aunt talked about him sometimes, about when they met and how it was a whirlwind romance. And she said, and he sure could dance. He volunteered. And I think he did that to kind of help them out of poverty. At the time he went into the service for African Americans, most of them did volunteer to go in. And I think it was to them hoping to get recognition as being somebody, and not knowing that, or not caring that, you know, their lives may be taken. But it was something that they wanted to contribute so that they could be known as people. So his platoon sergeant had gone, was already out, and I think he had been shot. And so he went out to save him, to pull him back, to save him, and he lost his life in doing that. And that shows that he cared about people. It didn't matter what color you were. It didn't matter what your rank was. And he cared about, he cared enough to try to help his sergeant live.
April the 8th, 2022 marks the 77th year of PFC James being killed in combat. So to honor him with a rose, to bring recognition for the community, to put a permanent marker at the Black Veterans Memorial.
My biggest thing that I think that motivated PFC James to overcome everything that he went through. He was in a single parent home, did not graduate from high school, and he worked at Crown Drugstore on 12th and Paseo. And I believe he felt a higher call that I need to do something to make sure that the next generation overcomes as this. And so he volunteered. African Americans was not drafted. And then once they went into the service, it was a lot of segregation. They were never sent to the front lines, or they had supply roles, and they did a lot of the cooking and supplies. The white soldiers was being depleted, and they was taking a lot of wounds and killed in action. And so they turned to the African Americans in the military on supply roads and asked them for volunteers. They asked for 5,000 volunteers, and they took 2,500 of those volunteers to go to the front line to fight the German. And PFC James was one of those 2,500 that went to the front line to bring recognition to PFC James. We're starting a nonprofit.
We want a big ceremony. We want his Medal of Honor to be displayed in the Black Archives. We want to have a statue of him. We want people to know who he was, what he did. I want our people, especially our young people, to be educated.
One of the most important things that I want to accomplish is to have a military honor ceremony, because as of right now, he never returned to Kansas City. He's buried in the Netherlands. And so I feel that the community of Kansas City owes him a proper military ceremony with a memorial in his hometown.
And I think it was all because of discrimination. Even to him receiving the Medal of Honor, the only way he received it is because Shaw University did a study with no reference to the nationality, race, ethnicity of the people, and they had to pick which ones, based on what they did, would deserve the Medal of Honor. And that's how he got chosen. Because of his bravery, because of what he did. And he should have received the Medal of Honor at that time, or it should have been given to his wife at that time.
I think it's important that we recognize African Americans in that served in World War II, because if you read a lot of articles and you look at a lot of things about World War II, you only see pretty much white soldiers, and it's another story that's part of our history that's there too. And so it's very important that we need to understand and know the sacrifice that the African Americans made during World War II.
The biggest thing is to just to get people to see and to know there is people that do go above and beyond, not only for themselves, but for others too.